Hello everyone, welcome to Creation by Souls second tutorial video. In my first video I showed you how to paint carnations. Today we are going to paint daisies. As you can see here, I've already painted one example for you here. I'm also going to include in this video an easy to paint background with smudging effect. For that I'm going to use colors like Prussian blue, Parisian green, Crimson Lake, Scarlet Lake, Deep Yellow, Cadmium Yellow, Titanium White, Cobalt Blue and Burnt Sienna. For that now I'm going to use a new plain canvas sheet. For the background I'm going to use Hog Hair Brush for the smudging effect. Because of its rough bristles, it provides little texture to the painting. First I am going to start with my first color, that is Prussian blue, followed by a Viridian green. So while we are painting the background, we are not going to use straight strokes. Rather we are doing zigzag strokes to provide the texture look. See how zigzag it is going. I'll go a little slow so that you can see it easily. Zigzag. See? We'll go zigzag here. And we will do it a little faster so that it won't dry up faster. So that we can merge our second color. And second color I'm going to use is Viridian green. We'll merge it. After we done with one color, I'm not gonna wipe my brush. In order to merge all the colors and to make sure that all the colors looks mixed into each other, so I will not wipe my brush. So I will not stop in between like this. I'll use little Viridian here to give it a darker look. Very greeny look. So yeah, we have to make our lower portion a bit darker than our upper one, and we will go like crisscross only, like zigzag. This is the advantage of a hog brush, so it will give a textured look for this zigzag effect. Again, we are going to use Prussian blue here, and we will repeat it there with more of green. So now we will use Crimson Lake, and we will start mixing from here only, so that it will give a merging here, one color into second color, and it will merge. Now we will take red more here. Now we will not use Viridian green and Prussian blue here. We will use here. So as you can see, I am not using a single drop of water or medium here. Now we'll use Scarlet Lake for more red effect here. As we go up, we will use more of our red. Scarlet Lake here. More of Scarlet Lake. And make sure there is no white space in our merging. So if you feel there is white space, so cover it with the color. Now scarlet more. Now permanent yellow. Now we are going to use lemon yellow, cadmium yellow, or lemon yellow. More yellow. So as you can see, we are going darker to more lighter, then lighter. Yeah. Now we are going to use titanium white, the most lighter color here. We will merge it here very gently so that it will seep in into our previous color. We have to do like this so that it goes here. You can see so many variation in colors after mixing white in it, the most light. While I'm letting this one dry, I already have a similar background ready which I'm gonna paint for the daisies. So I'll keep it as this one aside, and here I've already painted this. This one is dry. So we are going to start with our daisies. For that we'll use titanium white and cadmium yellow, permanent yellow, burnt sienna, and for the stem we are going to use viridian green. For our center part of the flower, I'm going to use a thin brush. Now I'll start with a lemon yellow to make a little idea where I'm going to place my first flower. So I'll make a dot here, then wipe my brush. Then I'll start with burnt sienna. I'm going to make a dotted effect with burnt sienna. Little bit round here, and over that I am going to use this permanent yellow here, so that it looks like a bit of lemon yellow here. See, for darker this here. So now this is the center of our daisy. Now we'll start with our daisy for the petals. I'm going to use number 2 brush, you know, round brush. We'll dip our brush with white and little bit of yellow, you know, and we want to place our brush here. We'll put little pressure here, more here, and we'll release it. This here. See? Pressure and release. Pressure and release. We'll use more of white here. Pressure and release. Pressure and then release. We'll turn our sheet according to this. We'll no color. And we'll turn our sheet accordingly. So that here. So this is our first daisy, as you see here. Now for our second daisy, again we'll make now for the second daisy, again we'll repeat the process same. We'll make a dot here for the idea, and we are not gonna place our flowers in one same line. Some will here up, some down. So for that, again in the round burn sienna with the dotted effect, again with little Persian blue for the darker. Again, we'll use permanent yellow and then a lemon yellow. Yeah. So now for the daisy, again we'll use this number 2 brush, white, little bit of lemon yellow, more of white and lemon yellow again. We'll start here. The process will be same. We'll put more pressure here and release. More pressure here, release. We'll turn our canvas sheet accordingly. So release. Release. Pressure here, release. Is coming automatically here. Release. And then release. So for the second daisy, again now for the third daisy we'll make it half. So again here one dotted, then burn sienna, take burn sienna, Prussian blue, again a dark effect, this here, more here, this time we're gonna make our daisy in this direction, so our petals will be in this downward direction. So I'll show how. Mix white, lemon yellow, so press, release, press, release, press, release, press, release, see in this direction. Press, release. Press, release. Press, release. Press, release. See. This time in this direction. We are not making full daisy here. We are making it this direction. Now, so we'll make more daisies here so that it would be easy for my viewers to understand. Now we'll make a different in daisy in different direction again for the center. I use this lemon yellow a little bit. This will give it a dotted effect, so it will look like we have shading in center. Now again we'll use for petals this here. Now we'll use in this, make it in this direction, in right direction. So press release, press release, press release, press release. We'll use yellow here. Press release, press release, press release. Now, next daisy again. This time we're gonna make full daisy. Dotted effect again. Make sure our center is not fully in circle. We have to make a little spherical here. So again, make. See how my hand is. Pressure, release. Pressure, release. Pressure, release. Pressure, release. Pressure, release. Release. Pressure, release. Pressure, release. Start here. See again the center dotted effect here. For darker thing, we'll use this. Now again, we'll start with one more daisy. Pressure, release. Pressure, release. Pressure, release. Now we are done with our daisy, so let it dry for a while. Now we are going to make stem. For that we'll use viridian green and lemon yellow. We'll take the same brush for the stem. Now, so we'll make a stem in one single stroke here. See, some in this direction, some in this direction, and some this, and we'll use lemon yellow in stem again for shading. Now we mix viridian with little bit white here. Now we'll make rough brush strokes so that it look like a cross. Very rough strokes here. So now I'm gonna mix my cobalt blue. And water here and make it more liquidy for the splashing effect to background. For the background, I'm gonna mix it well, make it very watery here, but not too watery so that it won't leave color. First, I'll do cobalt blue. So be very careful while splashing your color so that it won't come on our daisies. So we'll protect it from our hand. Here, see, here. We'll make it in different directions. Here. Keep control of your hand so that won't go on daisies. And for the second splashing, we are going to use Scarlet Lake. Again, we're gonna make it more watery here. Make it more watery for the splashing. Again, we'll keep a hand here so that it won't come on that easy. Same process. Yeah. Splashes on with different directions. Be careful and so that it won't come on. So we are done with our daisies here, as you can see. Thank you for watching this video. Please comment or share if you would like to learn anything in particular. Please drop in your suggestions in comment box and follow me on Facebook page Creation by Soul and on Instagram. Thank you so much.